Welcome back to Joyriding Gloves. You're standing inside the long white hangar at George W.S. Abbey Rocket Park. Outside, the cold winter rain hasn't let up since morning. You came here on a quiet Sunday, the only day off before work takes over your week. This stop here at the Saturn V hangar feels very personal. You zip up your jacket and step slowly along the pathway. On one side is a massive Saturn V rocket lying horizontally. On the other are tall white balls lined with mission plaques, each one a name, a number, a crew, and a moment in time. So you start at the beginning. On the far left side of the wall, you see the names AS-201, AS-202, and AS-203. These were NASA's early uncrewed test flights. They weren't headline missions, but they were critical. AS-201 flew in February 1966. It tested the command and service modules. The rocket launched, reached high altitude, and splashed down in the ocean. AS-202 followed in August of that year. That one tested heat shields and engine burns, longer flight time, deeper into data. AS-203 didn't carry any module. It tested fuel behavior and zero gravity. Then there's AS-204. You stop here as you notice the plaque doesn't say AS-204 anymore. It reads Apollo 1, but unfortunately, this mission never launched. In January 1967, during a test on the launch pad, a fire broke out inside the command module. Tragically, three astronauts died: Gus Grissom, Ed White, and Roger Chaffee. Their names are engraved under the mission patch. The patch is circular with the red border and their names. The middle shows the spacecraft orbiting Earth. You pause for a moment as you realize this tragedy changed how NASA approached safety. You move on as the walk continues with Apollo 7. This was the first successful crewed Apollo flight, launching in October 1968. Wally Schirra, Don Eisel, and Walter Cunningham spent 11 days in Earth orbit. Their goal? To test the command module in real conditions. It was thankfully a success. Next up is Apollo 8. It launched in December 1968. You stop here longer, admiring the view. The plaque shows three astronauts: Frank Borman, Jim Lovell, and Bill Anders. This was the first time humans left Earth orbit and flew around the moon. On Christmas Eve, they read from the book of Genesis while looking at Earthrise from the lunar horizon. NASA's site shares that broadcast. You can find the clip, and it's still quite a moving sight. Then Apollo 9. This one tested the lunar module in Earth orbit, docking and undocking, making sure it worked in space. The mission patch shows the module successfully flying free. Apollo 10 soon followed. It went all the way to the moon but didn't land. It meticulously rehearsed everything, such as descent and maneuvers, but left the final step to Apollo 11. Think of it like a dress rehearsal. The plaque even calls it the final test. Then comes the most famous of all, Apollo 11. July 1969, Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, Michael Collins. The wall here is much busier. The patch shows the Eagle landing on the moon, there's a larger QR code, and more visitors stopping here. Even if they don't know the full history, they know the moment. That's one small step for a man, one giant leap for mankind. You take a few steps further as you see Apollo 12 following quickly after. November 1969, Charles Pete Conrad and Alan Bean walked on the moon, while Richard Gordon stayed in orbit. The mission returned parts of the Surveyor 3 probe, which had landed years earlier. Then comes Apollo 13, and interestingly, the wall changes here. The mission patch shows three horses pulling a chariot, a nod to the Greek god Apollo. Below it, the word successful failure is printed. The oxygen tank explosion and the crew's safe return is all shown through a simple plaque. You remember the movie, but here it feels more real. There's even a screen nearby looping clips from the mission with Jim Lovell, Jack Swigert, and Fred Hayes. The next mission, Apollo 14, landed safely. Alan Shepard, the first American in space, returned to walk on the moon. He famously hit two golf balls on the lunar surface. The wall display shows the swing. And then Apollo 15 added the lunar rover. The mission lasted longer and the astronauts covered more ground. David Scott and James Irwin drove across the moon, and the rover is shown in photos nearby. The Apollo 16 explored the lunar highlands. John Young and Charles Duke collected over 200 pounds of samples. The mission patch shows a large eagle and the American flag. And finally, Apollo 17, the last moon landing, December 1972. Eugene Cernan and Harrison Schmitt walked on the moon. Schmitt was the only geologist to do so, while Cernan was the last man to leave footprints. As you look at the patch, you see another stylized profile of Apollo, the Greek god. The QR code links to NASA's official recap page. You can actually scan it with your phone. Outside, the wind picks up and the rain falls harder now. You zip up your jacket and look one last time at the giant Saturn V beside you. It's not just a rocket, it's a timeline. Each part on display connects back to the missions you just walked past. Now you've seen it with your own eyes. Not in a book or a screen, just 10 minutes inside this hangar on a quiet Houston Sunday. And still, it says so much. So which Apollo mission meant the most to you? Was it Apollo 1 sacrifice, Apollo 11's first step, or the tension of Apollo 13? So stay tuned and thanks for watching.